Hello again. In this tutorial, we are going to have a look at the dynamic parameters and how to handle them. But before we do that, let's have a quick look at what can be called a dynamic parameter. Here, if you look at this particular slide, we can split parameters in three categories. We have static ones. Static parameters are usually value we do not really care about in an application, typically sending something static, hence their name. Functional parameters are what we have taken care of in the tutorials before. Typically, login and password can be functional parameters. It could be the name or the address of the person being logged in the application. They are not mandatory. I mean, you must send a value, of course, but you don't absolutely have to send a different one for every script running during the test. But doing so will make it more realistic, in particular for the login and password. That's one of the most important ones. There are other parameters, though, parameters that are more related to how the application works, technically. And these kind of parameters, they usually look like they have random value that you cannot really make sense of. And these are typically IDs that are sent by the server to your brother during the navigation. And your brother takes them and reuses them in further requests. Typically here we have an example. You send a request to the server, and in one of the responses he will be giving you a value for a parameter that you're supposed to use in all further requests. This is just an example here, of course, but it's just to understand the principle before we actually go in OctoPerf and try to handle that. Now back to OctoPerf, we can see in this login request that we have a couple of values that do not really make sense per se. I suspect they are dynamic, so to find out if they are, what I'll do first is use a search again. But this time I will search in the response content, and that's why it's a good thing to have imported an HAR file that comes from Firefox or Fiddler, because here I will have this response content. And this would point me to where I was able to find this value at the recording time. If I click next here, I can see it's going to this request, which is actually marked right there. So I know it's supposed to be somewhere in the response in there. Let's go have a look to find out. We have the recorded response on the left, so I know it should be in this one. And I can use Control plus F to run a search here, searching for this exact value. So we can see we've been able to find it. It's actually a hidden input in the page that is called source page. And I don't know if you noticed, but at runtime, this parameter has an entirely different value. So it's probably going to be important to pick up the new value every time we run it. And to do that, we have a couple of ways. The most used one in OctoPerf is probably the regexp, because typically here we're not dealing with JSON, so the most relevant one will be the regex. Let's add a regex just under it by clicking this plus button. As you can see, I've added a regex under this get request. And here we are going to search in the response content. So the same thing we did earlier. But this time, since I'm doing it in the regex itself, it will create a basic regex for me. That's what we can see here. But it doesn't look like much for now because the left and right offset are pretty short. So I can make that better by increasing their size. Typically, I want to have at least the name of the parameter in my left boundary or my left offset, because this way I will have a more unique boundary. I will also increase the size of the right boundary here quite a bit, but it's not that mandatory. I think I was fine earlier. Anyway, we have a working regex now, so we can continue. There in the events menu, we can do whatever we want with the regex. So if you're comfortable with regex, you can go very far. But in my case, it will be more than enough to continue like this. And to continue, I would like to go to the check to see what's going on when I try to extract the value with this regex. It's actually picking up this value, which is fine by me. It looks like what I want to extract. We can also check if it will be working on the validate. And that can be done here by clicking validate. There we go. And I can see that it's extracting a value as well, so it looks correct. Of course, the value is different, but that was expected. So all of this tells me that my regex is working fine. Now we have two options to do the replacement. We could go to the post, request. See, that's a login request, login submit here, the one we were working on before. I could use the auto-completion like I did for the login and password and pixels page from the list here. That's a good way to proceed, but the problem I have with that is that you would have to identify all the occurrences manually and replace them all. You could automate some of this using the search and replace, of course, but that's not what we're looking for here because it's also error prone. Instead, what we can do is transform that into a correlation rule. Here, I can click this button to do that. Correlation rules are a kind of search and replace for regex that is automated for you, meaning that in here, we'll automatically search for this regex in all the responses. And whenever we can find something, we'll also replace it in the request. There are some filters you can use if you don't want to replace just anything in the request, but that will be okay for today. And know that if you're dealing with a standard application, we have frameworks here that you can use. So it's also a good way to handle these particular technologies. Let's just apply the regex here and see what's going on in our case. So I expect source page to be extracted and also to be replaced in the next post. Let's see about that. There we go. But actually, there's also another one later on. In fact, every time we submit something, we have a new value for source page. You see, it's been extracted from the previous request, and it's also been replaced in the next response. So now, if I import another HAR file, I will have source page taken care of automatically by going to correlation rules. Let's run the script and see if that works in the end. So I will run it again from Paris. And this time we'll pay particular attention to the value of source page in what's replayed. The idea, of course, is that we want to see if source page has a different value at runtime and make sure that what we've done is working fine. So again, the validation is running. We see if we have a green dot here. So that means it has already replayed. We can go and have a look here. What I'm interested into with the request, so let's close this panel. And as you can see, yes, source page has a different value at runtime. And checking the response, well, we can see it's fine as well. So it looks okay, and we know what we've been doing is working fine. Well, that will be enough for this video. In the next one, we'll have a look at other logic actions we can use to have more control over what this user is doing, and we'll try to take the design a bit faster. So let's see you in the next tutorial of OctoPerf. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.